Good morning, everyone, ladies and gentlemen. I wish to thank Professor Lukowski and Unipress for inviting me here to speak about Nanoforce. I'll try to be fast, as I know all the people here has a technical background. I will not speak too much about technical stuff, more about organizational, and try to inform the public about the opportunity to support such a startup in nanotech domain. It has been very interesting to listen about the Nanovelos enterprises. It is very nice and very bright and brilliant, as Darius has been able to evoke the opportunity to start a business with the nanotechnology. But it's very difficult to find such opportunities nowadays. I think that not all nanotech developments will be able to support such a brilliant, we don't have such a, all students are not entrepreneurs, willing to be entrepreneurs. We must improve this kind of bright prospect for the researchers. So this is where we start the point. Nanoforce is a European funded project that is willing to improve the prospect for startup business in nanotech domain. We know that the partners of Nanoforce are seven countries in Central Europe, and in Central Europe the entrepreneurship is something that is not supported as we are willing to do in Western countries, in the US. We have very different ability to support with the organization and public. So, here we go. As a foreword, I will just provide some figure about the opportunity to start up a business in nanotech with nanotechnology focus. Global sales of products manufactured incorporating nanotechnologies have been estimated more than $250 billion in 2009. This is just an estimate. In 2015, as we have heard even yesterday during another presentation from a Portuguese colleague, we had the figure of about $3 trillion in 2015. This is just the overall market incorporating nanotech. And the world government invested during the last decade more than $65 billion in nanofocused R&D activities. These, I wanted to report some of the sectors that have been touched by the hype of nanotech developments. This is just to provide you the information how much far we can go. Nanotechnologies like chemistry touch almost all the sectors that we have in the economy today, all the manufacturing sectors. Medicine is very nice, it's very important. We have a lot of bright development ahead, but there are all the traditional sectors that can be improved, the efficiency of the sectors, the ability to provide new products. So, for example, for transport and aerospace, of course, nanotechnology can provide lighter products, more resistance and more robust. In the food and packaging industry, again, we can have new products that are improving the shelf life of products. Nanomedicine, we have seen already some proposal from Nanovelos, and energy, again, the duration of the batteries. It's energy in clean tech is something that is really important today for our planet and our further developing economy, just to provide the energy to the increasing population of our planet. Again, electronics, materials, I don't want, I think that this presentation will be available, so I don't would like to not to lose too much time reading this kind of information that is very common now. This is just to provide a complete framework of the situation where we are. The risk that the European is lagging behind is quite high. We have a good science based in our countries. This is the data from Scientific and Lux Research. European Union R&D accounts for 27 of world public grants in nanotech, but only a tiny part of these are able to register patents and to provide the basis of business for tomorrow's. And again, only a little part, even more little, are the share of new products that are built with this kind of nanotechnology developments. But it's still important. So we have already a good part of our economy that is increasing, not at the pace as we would like to see. So here we come with the Nanoforce project. This is co-financed by the structural funds, and it is been assigned to Central Europe. The project started in 2011, and it will end next year, the beginning of next year. And the project is performed by 9 partners in 7 countries. We have 2 Polish partners. One is the hosting Unipress, and the other one is the Polish Chamber of Chemical Industry. We have even 2 Italian partners. Ourselves, that is Viluppo Chimica, is the service company owned by the Federation of Chemical Industry in Italy, and the Veneto Nanotech. Veneto Nanotech is the subject that is promoting nanotechnology in Italy, and it's quite interesting to know that Veneto region is quite important region about manufacturing in Italy, but it's almost completely structured with small medium enterprises tissue. There are almost not big players in manufacturing. So this Veneto Nanotech has been created by the region of Veneto to support the improving or the quality of the products realized by these small medium enterprises tissue. And they are belonging to almost all the industry sectors, from fertilizers to plastics to whatever. So this is the area. We can see the logo from Unipress and then of that other 8 partners. The most developed area is probably Bavaria, so with a chemical cluster Bayer, but the other are Czech Republic, Slovak Republic and Slovenia, more than Poland in northern Italy, and they all share the same attitude to support business. We can dramatically improve the way we are going to support a new startup development. We are lagging far from Western European countries. The project is structured in the work packages. The most important, we leave VP1 is for organization and management, the second is for communication, the third one is a mapping of the infrastructure of nanotechnology within these regions. VP4 is dedicated to technical matters like the trying to reduce the barrier of safety for nanomaterials. Number 5 is supporting nano and R&D and commercialization and industrialization. And then VP6, we will speak briefly about that, is about the proposal to start up a venture capital fund within interregional. So we want to design and set up a proposal to fund an interregional arms for venture capital, trying to increase the resources that are channeled to this kind of enterprise. So most of the activities are determined. They are, we want to help researchers self-assess their incapacity to start up a new business. We want to train them regarding the basic on business, provide them the toolbox to start up a business. And then we want to make them meet each other to start up a collaboration projects to partners. We listened a lot of time yesterday about the need to partners with other. Open innovation concept required it's asking us not to try to develop everyone all the things that we need to start up a business, because we can't do that. you must to focus on your expertise, and then you have to partner with someone other that is provided the excellence you need to perform your task. And that's why the mapping regional stakeholder infrastructures is very important. You need to know who other is working on that kind of topics. And then we decided to develop a platform, a database informing us who is acting in this kind of sectors. And here we are looking at the homepage of our website, Nanoforce Project, www.nanoforceproject.eu. If you will register and login in, then you will be able to find relevant documents that are going to be developed. Just as an example, I will not speak, I said, about technical scientific activity that is carried out during the project, but there is a task that is aiming at developing some safety data sheet, some excerpt about the problem of reach registration about nanotechnology, about nanoparticles. We know that the reach is covering all the topics, including nanoparticles and nanomaterials. But there are some protocols and some idea to improve the way we are doing this kind of safety analysis. How do the chemical safety report and so on. So this is an activity that is aiming at produce some info. The technical table that has been organized is organized within Nanoforce Project 2. So you can apply as an expert or search for a specific one. Place yourself as an actor and discover your talents as a fresh PhD. We will see how we want to help talents come out. Propose and evaluate research ideas and business plan and search for new business deals and identify nanotech opportunities. Then we indicated even find a place where to establish your business. We developed a brochure for the nanotech valleys, we call it. In Central Europe, we asked to map all the incubators, all the scientific and technological park that can host new companies and the service they provide. So there is the opportunity to start a competitive competition between these incubators, because they must improve their service, they must help companies obtain the funds, private funds from venture capitalists or public funds from a European Commission, whatever, but they must improve the ability to help researchers start up a business. So we say the way we are willing to provide this kind of service are fostering matching and networking between stakeholders in nanotech. Stakeholders are in very in wide sense. Everyone that is aiming to support this kind of nanotech development. We said about partnership, I again repeat, open innovation is something even the biggest companies are doing. Even the biggest company know that they, Procter & Gamble, can't develop everything inside. They must rely to the best in class technology that can be nanovelos technologies or whatever. You have to rely to bright students and you have to find them. And this is a way, asking them to report and try to indicate what are their expertise and try to make them more visible. Then promoting the safe industrial application. This is what we said about technical work that we are doing. Unipress is helping a lot, but all the partners in Nanoforce Project are trying to improve the documentation and help them build a safety data sheet or whatever needs to comply for reach regulation to start up any business. And finally, we are trying to support the research willing to turn laboratory results into innovative industrial application. This is very general. This is means we want to provide them with the information needed to start up a business, not only business information and a toolbox for to know how to behave and try to attract capitals. This is means all the activities that are needed to finance their research activities and to try to develop a product that is able to sell in the market. Between the main characteristics, we know that nanotechnology includes a lot of technical fields, from physics to chemistry, material science, and these are all included. This is one of the difficulties we have. We are not speaking with only one specific researcher with a single focus. We have to speak a lot with others that are coming from side science. And this is reflected even in the hypotagging system for the search and classification of patents. The novelty is not just miniaturization. We have to identify new ability to resolve the needs that we want to satisfy with our products. Chemical industry. We supported this project because we are supporting Italian chemical companies. Most of the partners of the Nanoforce project come from chemical industry too. They are federations. We have the Polish Federation of Chemical Industry, we have the Czech Federation of Chemical Industry, and the Slovak one. So chemical industry is something that is very interested to nanotech development, of course, because this kind of developments are the same. They are moving in the same environment, and they are trying to resolve some problem in sustainability. They are trying to improve their product offer in terms of quality, because they have to compete on international basis. In Italy, they run for example, the energy costs are higher than usually. They have a lot of problem in organization, red tape. So we have to improve the overall, as we are doing for chemical industry. That's why we wanted to start. So this is a concept of chemical consumption, just very fast. For example, here we have the chemical products. We are the market destination. I know that it's very little, just for mention. Technical gases are chemical products that are used by a lot of different sectors. So we are trying to support nanotechnology developers that are impacts in multiple sectors. That's what the peculiarity of chemistry. Chemistry is not aiming at a single market. About the funding, very fast, because time is, I know it's running short. We know this concept. We have a problem. Excellence, science is from one side, the industry is on the other, and we have a lot of gap to fill to improve the sector. And here we can see which are the funds that we want to increase in order to support a nanotech business startup. Founder and families, of course, we can't do too much about things, but we want to increase the resources that are channeled through public grants and venture capital or business angel. This is the actual today funding framework. We have a lot of, almost half are government's funds, and the other half are corporation funds. But we have a tiny fraction that are equity investment, and this can leverage a lot of resources. So this is the lever that we must to employ. Source of fundings. Most of the companies receive public grants, and only some of them receive private invest venture capitals. Most of them are in the energy and electronics. A lot of them are just have a tiny fraction from venture capital, so we have to work on this kind of sector. And this is how much money is provided by European Union through the framework program 7. This looks quite a lot, but this is a general, non-specific framework. We have no only NMP that is a part of that. So the idea for the public grants. Public grants, we would like to support the researchers that will come to Nanoforce through the definition of an entire path. We start from idea support and proof of concept. We have a lot of programs that are financing them in European Union, from ideas of FP7, now we are going to Horizon 2020, but there will be probably something financing these ideas. Marie Curie, Academy Industry Partnership, and National Initiatives. This is the idea that comes from the laboratory. Next, we have the research and development area with NMP. And again, next, we have demonstration and pilot plant facilities that come from Eco Innovation Life Plus. So each of the researchers that will be willing to start up an idea should follow this path from each, like are doing enterprises. Enterprises takes the maximum from the public to reduce the risk. And this is the same way that we should feel follow with the researchers. So this now will be only a few slides regarding the registering session for Nanoforce, and then I will quit. Just a few. This is the website, as I said. There is a part within the research and venture capitalist menu, which is aiming to gather the registering intentions from researcher. If you want to submit your proposal, you just have to log in this part of the menu, and then you will be required to insert your username and password. Of course, if it's the first time you enter the site, you will be required to register here. After a few data, you will be asked even to provide the confidential, the privacy tick in a box, because if you do not agree, of course, you will not appear about the proposer. And if you're not able to appear between the proposer, then you will not be allowed, of course, to insert information. We are not able to present your idea to investors, and this is where we come with the database. Here is the database are listed all the enterprise initiatives, and this is only one side of the database, because on the other side we have the capitalists. I know this is not the place where I should present how to do that, but we are listing all the venture capitalists that are willing to see your business plan. So if you are willing to let someone evaluate your proposal, you should probably or identify directly or list in the register in your database session. Then we have the last one, the discover your talent. We are launching SON, the technology rating system. This is a software that is asking you some questions and trying to provide some information how to best exploit your patent or your know-how if you don't have a patent. So next step will be the proposal to set up a venture capital fund. This is for institutional investors, and this is a document that will be available and presented in next three events that we are going to launch in SOM. The next week in Prague, 1st of October in Vienna, and the final one in Milan. Plus, please remember that we have a Nano Challenge in Italy that is an opportunity to present your business plan if you have any idea. Nanotech Italy 2013 will have a session inside providing the opportunity to meet some venture capitalists. And most of them are the same that you have seen in the list before. So they are focused, interested in nanotechnology. So thank you.